Has Donald Trump finally gone too far? His latest comments possibly causing a wedge in the Republican Party. Hugh Hewitt is here, one of the highlights of my week. He's the host of the Hugh Hewitt
Show. Hey, John.
Hugh, good to have you, especially on this evening when we have this from Donald Trump. He wants to ban all Muslims from traveling into this country. Some of the reactions from fellow Republicans, really the reactions have been scathing. What are you hearing?
Well, I had Vice President Cheney on my program tonight, and the Vice President, now not specifically referring to Donald Trump, rejected the policy that Donald Trump put forward. And I think tomorrow morning's broadcast on New Day, when Chris Cuomo talks to Donald Trump, may be the highest rated New Day ever, because I'll be turning in early to find out what Chris, who's a very expert and skilled inquisitor, asked Donald Trump about what he meant and the nuances of that. I know that next week's debate on Tuesday night got more complicated and more interesting today.
Hey, so, don't get ahead of me. We're going to talk about that. So, but listen, let's, right. And you're right, I think it's going to be fascinating tomorrow. But let's listen to what Dick Cheney said to you today, which you just referenced. Listen.
Yep.
Well, I think this whole notion that somehow we can just say no more Muslims, just ban a whole religion, goes against everything we stand for and believe in. I mean, religious freedom has been a very important part of our history and where we were, came from. A lot of people here, my ancestors got here because they were Puritans. There wasn't anybody here then when they came. But it's a mistaken notion.
This is one of the bold names, really, of the Republican Party. He is known to be a hardliner. So my question is Donald, is this even too far for Donald Trump?
Well, I don't know. We'll find out as the days go on what people react and how he refines and extends his remarks. You know, Dick Cheney has worked very closely with all sorts of Muslim leaders around the world, King Hussein. He mentioned later tonight at a conversation we had at Colorado Christian University, his conversation with King Fahd at the time of the Gulf War. He knows that Indonesia and Malaysia are Muslim countries that we rely upon for freedom of the seas. He knows we've got a lot of Muslim allies. So Vice President Cheney has a very nuanced and deep understanding of America's relationship with the Muslim world. And I think tomorrow, when Chris Cuomo talks to Donald Trump, there'll be some good questions to be asked and answered. Thus far, no one in the Republican primary has sided with Donald Trump on this. So that
does Donald Trump have the kind of understanding that you just referenced?
I don't know. We'll find out. You know, on Tuesday night's debate, there will be questions that will dive into that. But I'm pledged, as is Wolf, as is Dana, as are you, Don, to impartiality when it comes to the candidates and to ask them to explain at length and in detail. And if I were CNN, and I'm not, it's up to you and Jeff Zucker to figure this out tomorrow, I would blow out the whole hour and give it to Chris Cuomo and Donald Trump to explore this, because we had a terrorist attack in California last week, in my backyard. And the Center for Security Policy's poll, which has been online since June of last year, and by the way, I've got to correct Jeff Zelny, Frank Gaffney and the Center for Security Policy are not a hate group. The Southern Poverty Law Center almost got people killed 2 years ago when they labeled the Family Research Council as a hate group. And I reject the idea that we should be using these terms broadly, rapidly, or irresponsibly. I think tomorrow Chris has his work cut out for him to get Donald Trump to expand upon and be very precise. What did he mean? What did he have in mind? And I think that conversation will continue through to Tuesday, and I intend to be fair, and I think we all ought to be fair and let him speak for himself.
Okay, good. That was my next question. If you think it by then, because, you know, in this whole Donald Trump age, right, this presidential age that when he's running, that he can change the conversation, which he did about immigration, when he talked about Mexicans, when he did about Muslims now and about terrorism, whatever. He does have a way of saying these things that many people find outrageous, whether you think it is or not, and he sort of leads a conversation with them. I think by Tuesday, you think by Tuesday, this will still be a huge topic worth delving into for a long time at the debate?
Oh, I think the issue of terror in America and who do we let into America, given the example of what happened in San Bernardino, is a huge issue. Obviously, what we believe now is that the woman of the terrorist pair was a black widow, was sent here with that intention, that she came here to kill Americans. And we have to make sure that the system does not allow for repetition of that. And so does he refine and extend his remarks in such a way as to persuade people he had nothing other than that in mind? We'll find out. He'll be on with Chris tomorrow morning, and I mean, I'm going to get up to watch that because I want to know what he means. At the same time, We have many millions of American Muslims who cannot feel threatened in their homes, who are protected by constitutional mm-hmm. rights. We have tens of millions, hundreds of millions of Muslim allies around the world who hate having their religion hijacked by these extremists, as Michael Weiss describes in his book, ISIS. So yeah. We'll see tomorrow morning.
We'll see. And as you said, give it an hour. That's not up to me. That's up to Donald Trump and Chris and Jeff, because let's see if he hangs on long enough for an hour. Who knows? I think Chris can handle himself yeah. for an hour. I would, I think that could happen. Thank you. Appreciate it.